Southeast Asia, yellow is traditionally the color of royalty. The first independence from the Netherlands on 17 August 1958. The flag is similar to the flag of Britain, flag of Singapore. The flag is identical to the flag of Hesse, the German state, and the flag of excluding the ratio. Red represents courage, while white represents purity of freedom. The flags represent blood, red, and scary white. The national flag of Singapore was adopted in 1959, the year Singapore became self-governing within the British Empire. It was reconfirmed as the national flag when the Republic gained independence on 9 August 1965. The design is a horizontal bicolor of red above white, overlaid in the canton, upper left for the by a white person worn facing a pentagon of five small white five-pointed stars. The elements of the flag denote a young nation of the ascendant, universal brotherhood and equality and national ideals. The flag of Malaysia, also known as the Malay for stripes and crown. It comprises a few of 14 alternating red and white stripes along the flag and a blue canton bearing a crescent and a 14-point star known as the Mountain Passion. The 14 stripes of equal width represent the equal status in the Federation of the 13 member states and the federal government. The 14 points of the star represent the unity between these entities. The crescent represents Islam, the country's official religion. The blue canton symbolizes the unity of Malaysian people. The yellow of the star and crescent is the royal color.
Peace and tranquility and courage and decisiveness.
The flag of Vietnam is also called red flag with the gold star. Red symbolizes revolution and blood. The star represents the five main classes in Vietnamese society: intellectuals, farmers, workers, businessmen, and military personnel. The Cambodian flag has featured a description of Angkor Wat in the center. The current flag, with a blue border and red central, was adopted following Cambodia's independence in 1948. The national flag of the Philippines is also called the Three Stars and the Sun. It's a horizontal flag bicolor with equal bands of blue and scarlet, and with a white equilateral triangle at the host. In the center of the triangle is a golden yellow sun with eight primary rays, each representing a Philippine province. At each vertex of the triangle is a five-pointed golden yellow star, of which representing one of the country's three main island groups, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Helmet. A unique feature of this flag is its ability to indicate a state of war if it's displayed with the red side on top. The capital of Indonesia is Jakarta. The capital of Cambodia is Phnom Penh. The capital of Vietnam is Hanoi. The capital of Myanmar is Nai Pi Daw. The capital of Laos is Vientiane. The capital of Thailand is Bangkok. The capital of Malaysia is Kuala Lumpur. The capital of Brunei is Bandar Seri Begawan. The capital of Singapore is still Singapore. The capital of the Philippines is Manila. In Indonesia, there are low-rise buildings which are old. And in Cambodia, there is a mixture of high-rise and low-rise buildings which are new and old. In Vietnam, there are mostly low-rise buildings which are old, and in Myanmar, a mixture of high-rise and low-rise buildings which are new and old. In Laos, there are low-rise buildings which are old, and in Thailand, there's a mixture of high-rise and low-rise buildings which are new and old. In Malaysia, it's the same, as there are also a mixture of high-rise and low-rise buildings which are new and old. And in Brunei, there are low-rise buildings. In Singapore, there are high-rise buildings which are mostly new. And in Philippines, there are low-rise buildings which are old. Now I'll pass the time to Nicole. Now I will be presenting to you the population size and land area of the countries in Southeast Asia. Here is a pie chart of the population size of the countries in Southeast Asia. The population of Brunei is 0.4 million, Cambodia 15.3 million, Indonesia 234.2 million, Laos 6.2 million, Malaysia 28.9 million, Myanmar 60.2 million, Philippines 94 million, Singapore 5.1 million, Thailand 67.3 million, and Vietnam 86.9 million. Thus, the entire population size of the countries in Southeast Asia is 618 million, and the size 4.5 square kilometers. Now, I'll pass my time to Wesley.
Now, I'd like to share about the different languages of by Southeast Asia in the climate of Southeast Asia. The language of Southeast is English, Chinese, Malay, Tamil, Burmese, Vietnam, Thai, Bar, Indonesia, Filipino, and Portuguese.
Wesley, hold the top. Hold the mic top. Higher, yes.
In winter, monsoon from the north blow into East Asia and cause cold, dry weather. The wind changes direction in summer and blows from the seas that lie south and southeast of that region, causing hot, humid weather. wonder how the climate affects the type of activities in countries. Well, here are some examples. The blue climate at Ghana, green is good for growing strawberries, and in the tropical climate of Korea, diseases like malaria and yellow fever are prevalent. This is a description of the houses that people live near or in the forest we have. They are dry grass roads. The main beams are made of hardwood and the walls are and flooring are made of bamboo. Here are the houses in Singapore compared to houses in forests. Houses in Singapore are mostly high-rise, made of bricks and have tile floors and are new, while the houses in forests have stilts made of wood, bamboo flooring and are old. Thus, we must appreciate what we have in Singapore and not take them for granted. Now I would like to pass the time out.
Now I would like to share the advantages and disadvantages of mountains, rivers and lakes. Mountains are good as they are good tourist attractions, can collect water and store it, and also can counterbalance other mountains to stabilize Earth's orbit, and can provide dividing lands for countries. The advantages of rivers and lakes are that they can provide us with prime opportunities for recreation, tourism, cottage or residential living. Maybe a source of raw drinking water, and you can also use the river to get from place to place. However, the river may flood when it rains very heavily, and there are also billions of river moths during the hot summer months. So, you see, lakes are more than just a single body of water used by many people to enjoy recreational activities. They are also important ecosystems. Thus, we must know that it is our responsibility to continue to practice stewardship in our lakes by keeping them healthy for all, especially those who depend on them. The good things about volcanoes are that they provide resources for energy extraction, also known as geothermal resources. This involves heat from the Earth's crust is being converted to energy. The big advantages to this type of energy are that it is very clean and the resources are nearly inexhaustible. They will bring more tourism and more tourism jobs available. This will bring more money in the local economy through airport tickets, tourism guides or companies, hotels, restaurants, and local showbiz companies and everything. Now I will pass to the time to focus again.
However, when the volcano erupts, transport and communication will be blocked. This will stop people getting out of police and ambulance getting in. The lava flows will also cover and block the roads. Communication with air patrol and outside help will be lost, as on the inside, the roads are blocked for land transport. Crops will also be ruined. When a cloud of ash overshadows the town or city, the cloud will collapse and there will be no escape. See, during a volcano erupt, earthquakes happen and tsunamis may be created. Also, if it is a volcano island, the island may be destroyed and there is no escape. We have come to the end of the presentation. Thank you for your kind attention.